remarketing stuff last time, and today we're gonna talk about WordPress website development. So Rahul, I've been in asking you multiple times. Either I have to chuck you out of this room if you're not gonna unmute yourself. I am not really sure, Manoj, actually, where exactly is he on the WhatsApp number. So I think he's doing it deliberately, nothing else. All right, so did you guys practice doing that with your, so Santosh, I had sent you across your Google AdWords, what do you say? The coupon, right? Okay, thanks Rahul for being on mute. Thank you so much. So what I'm saying, I did send across the coupon to you, Santosh. Did you receive that? I would show you how to get the coupon code also implemented within your Google AdWords account. So that's going to be first thing, right? So which I'm going to showcase that across to you. So I'll just get started with, and then after that we'll be, start with creation of a WordPress based website, guys. So before I begin, any doubts or queries, guys, from the last session? So Santosh, Nitin, if you were here. Just give me a moment. So right, so we would first of all try to configure. I would show you first of all how to get the coupon code implemented, guys, in your advert panel. All right. Okay, so whomsoever I have given the coupon code, so Nitin, Manoj, and Santosh, I can give you guys a coupon code. So coupon codes, I would be giving 15 coupon codes to every DMP subscriber. So whosoever is a DMP subscriber, I would give you the 30,000 rupees worth of coupon code. So for every account, you can actually use one specific coupon, which is going to be about 2,000 rupees. All right. So I'm just waiting for some more people to join in, and then I'm going to begin with it so that they don't miss it. Prior to that, sure, Manoj. So what I need, in case you need these coupons, you have to give, you have to create a new Gmail account, and with that new Gmail account, you have to sign up on adwords.google.com. Make sure this new account is just 14 days old. That's it, right? So just 14 days old your account should be, and once you give me the Gmail account, I would send you across the coupon, which is going to be for 2,000 rupees. But the point is that you have to spend 2,000 first from your pocket, and then Google will give you 2,000 more. So it's like if I'm giving you 2,000 rupees coupon, you have to spend 2,000 rupees worth of money on the Google AdWords campaign, and then you'll get 2,000 worth rupees more. So all in all, you get 4,000 rupees, but at a cost of 2,000 rupees only. From your pocket, it will be 2,000, but overall, you get 4,000 rupees, right? So I have someone else joining in by the name of Lenovo. Can I get to know your name, please? So I'll just get started in another 3 minutes, guys, so that All right, so I've shared across the URL for the videos of the sessions we're gonna have, guys. So I upload all the videos, recordings. Last session's video is not uploaded. There was some problem with the video. I'm gonna configure that and going to do that. So most of the lessons, the PPTs, PowerPoint presentations I used, I've shared the URL for that also, and I've shared the URL for the videos part also. Before I begin, I just want to let you know, if you would click on the very first one, the DMP videos one, you would land onto the YouTube channel of DMP, and the second one, and the second link, if you would click on that, you would get to the page where all the lessons are being mentioned. So whatever topics we are covering, all that is right up here, right? So all those who have joined in for the very first time, it's Prince, Omkar, and also Rahul Roy, and someone by the name of Lenovo. Can you type in the chat window or change your name from Lenovo to your exact name? Can you also let us know your small brief introduction, please? So Santosh, yes, Santosh, I can hear you. We can see your chat. So okay, Priyanka, can you change your name, Priyanka? And is it the first time are you attending this session? All right, this is the first time. So Priyanka, what's your background like? All right, Priyanka, Omkar, that's your first time too, and Rahul, that's your first time as well. Guys, can you give us a small brief, and I would give my introduction too before I begin. And then we're just waiting for more people to join in. So let us know if are you a working professional? If yes, then what profession are you into, and what exactly you're looking at from learning digital marketing? So I've shared across my credentials, guys, my email ID, my number in case you want to get in touch with me on WhatsApp, and my LinkedIn URL as well, my LinkedIn profile URL. So my name is Nick Bartla, and I am taking care of entire digital marketing online classes, online trainings with Digital Marketing Pathshala. And I've been into this industry for the past 15 years. I have handled multiple clients all over the globe in terms of meeting their digital marketing needs. And I'm running an organization which is a Canadian marketing association, sorry, Canadian internet marketing agency called Yo Creations. All right, so it's been almost close to 6 years I have been working on this. I've been taking care of it. All right, so we have Omkar saying, I'm a diploma student doing mechanical but interested in website development and want to get digital marketing knowledge. All right, thanks, Omkar. And Rahul says, I'm working as an SMO executive and I have 4 years experience. I want to be an expert. All right, thank you. And Priyanka says, I'm Priyanka. I have done my MBA in HR and worked in consultancy for 6 months, but want to learn something new. That's great. Thank you so much, guys. And what part of India are you from? So it's 3:01. We'll get started in a while. What part of so just to we have people from all across other regions of the India. So we have Manoj from Delhi, Nitin from Punjab, Ludhiana. Then we have Santosh from Karnataka, Bangalore. And okay, no problem, Santosh. It's perfectly fine. Okay, so Priyanka, you're from Aurangabad, Maharashtra. All right, thanks a lot for. And Omkar says Omkar is from Pune, Maharashtra. All right, great, thanks. And Rahul, where exactly are you from? So I have shared a couple of links with you guys, And that's my about the videos part and also the lessons part. So you're from Gorakhpur, all right. Thanks, Rahul. And I'm also sharing a link which I would be using. So before you leave the today's session, I would request you to share your feedback also once you leave. So I've shared with you the feedback link, guys. All right, so let's get started. And let's get started with, first of all, understanding. So last time we had covered, this is an ongoing batch which is covered going right now, but it's perfectly fine if you're coming in for the very first time, because the topic which we're going to take today is something. So the topic which we're taking today has got no relation with what we have done earlier on. All right. So right now, first of all, I'm trying to address a particular question which I had. How do we go ahead and get the coupon code implemented? All right. So this is the AdWords panel, guys. All right. Yes, Rahul. Yeah, you are also joining for the first time. Got you. Welcome, guys. And welcome, Dhruv. You have also joined in right now. So yeah, this is the AdWords panel, guys. What I would do, if you see the gear icon right up here, right? Go into the gear icon in order to get your coupon code implemented. Click on the gear icon, and after that, click on the accounts, sorry, the billing section rather, the billing tab in the account, the gears tab. Once you click on the gear icon, click on the billing tab. And once you do that, you would get to see if you have entered your, let's say, your debit card or your credit card details earlier on, then this is the kind of screen which you would get to see. If not, then you would need to submit across your debit card details or credit card details. It's up to you how much money you want to spend. That's perfectly fine, whether it's 100 rupees or 500 rupees or 50 rupees, whatever. Once you do that, once you submit across your debit card or credit card details, you would simply go and click on Manage Promotional Codes. Okay, click on Manage Promotional Codes button. So I repeat again, you went to the gear icon, and after gear icon, you went ahead and pressed on the billing tab. After clicking on the billing tab, you clicked on the Manage Promotional Code, and you can see the plus promotional code. All right. So click on the plus promotional code, guys, and enter your promotional code. Now, I would be giving you the code which I have entered over here is actually valid for 750 rupees only. So the one which I have used gives me 750 rupees worth of advertisement free. That will only be available to me if I would spend 750 first of all from my pocket. It says get rupees 750 credit for spending rupees 750 on AdWords. All right. So I've just now spent just 579 rupees. And if I would be able to spend, I think up till it's valid till 1st September, right? So till 1st September, if I'm able to spend 750 rupees, I would get 750 top up as a gift because of the promotional code which I would enter in, right? So I would be giving you the 2000 rupees one, all right? So the code which you would enter here would give you 2000 rupees more if you end up spending 2000 first of all from your pocket. That's actually something which is a prerequisite. All right, you would go ahead and submit that across, and you would be done. So all those who are digital DMP subscribers, they would be getting 15 overall, AdWords coupons which are valued for 30,000 rupees. I would be giving them. Plus, I also offer free website. So the free website which I offer, are we going to just talk about that also? We're going to configure our website today. I'll show you how do you book a domain, then get a hosting from the cPanel hosting, cPanel of the hosting provider. How do you get the WordPress installed? And after you install the WordPress, how do you go ahead and buy a theme? And after buying a theme, how do you go ahead and upload a theme and then import demo content? So all these tactics we would configure. If time would permit us, then we will also go ahead and configure Google Analytics. Google Analytics is actually a tool which Google allows you to track the overall traffic on your website.
All right. So all those who have joined in new, if you want to really see what have we done in the past, you can definitely visit the URL which I have already shared with you. And that's for everybody. If you want to keep a track of what all stuff we keep covering, the sessions get recorded and they are being uploaded right across here. I hope you can see my chat. In the chat window, I have mentioned the URL for the videos part. And also I'm mentioning the URL mentioning where all the lessons, all the PowerPoint presentations are mentioned. And the third URL which I'm mentioning is a feedback link, guys, which I always try to collect feedback at the end of the session. In case you still have any sort of suggestion from your end, which you want to submit across, which you want to, you have a question to ask, you can simply go to bit.ly/DMP-feedback and submit across your details there. All right, guys. So all those who have joined in for the first time, they can mention whatever queries they have within that feedback link also, or over the chat, whatever doubts or queries you have. All right. So let's get started. I hope everybody is clear on how to get the promotional code activated, how to enter the promotional code in the AdWords account. Can I get a yes or a no in the chat window? If you have got it, yes. If not, then no. Rahul says yes. Dhruv says yes. All right. How about others? Priyanka, Manoj, Nitin. Then we have Prince. All right. Priyanka has got that. All right. So Prince, you haven't got that. Prince, can you let me know what exactly you haven't got so far? Santosh, I hope you have all. So I have given very recently, I have offered a promotional code to Santosh. And I just want to check whether you have also got that or not. Maybe there's some problem at his hand from the internet side. All right. So I'll repeat that again, Prince. Just have a look. What I did in terms of entering the free promotional code for Google AdWords, you first of all need to have a new account. You need to send the Gmail ID to me. I would give you the promotional code. All right. And that is actually for all those DMP subscribers. And once you give me the Gmail code, I would give you the promotional code. All you need to do is log into your AdWords account, which is adwords.google.com, and then go to the gear icon. You have a gear icon on the right hand side. Click on that and then go to billing. So I'm just. Okay. So Santosh, I hope it's perfectly fine. You have understood what I have been. I have told you the process. Right. So once I click on the gear icon, then there is this. Then you need to enter your debit or credit card details. Once you enter your debit or credit card details, guys, it will ask you for manage promotional codes. You can see it's right up over here. Click on manage promotional code. All right. So after clicking on manage promotional code, guys, you would need to click on the plus promotional code and just enter your promotional code. That's it. So are you okay with it, Prince? Is that clear? All right, great. So Prince, that's your actual name or? Okay, fine. So let's get started. All right, thanks. So let's get started with building a WordPress-based website, guys. So for building a website, we need three major things. I would write that down. One is a website domain. Number two is a website hosting. And number three, so Dhruv says, so spending X amount, we get the same amount. Absolutely right, Dhruv. Right. So majorly the coupons which I have right now are the 2000 rupees one. So in case you need that, since you are a paid part of, you are a paid customer of DMP, I would give you maximum 15 coupons, which are valued at 30,000 rupees. I can give you that. All right. So one very first thing is website domain we need for building up of a website. Number two is website hosting. And number three thing, guys, is a template. So I am teaching you a WordPress based website. So a WordPress is one of a CMS, guys. When I say CMS, CMS means content management system. What exactly a content management system is, it's actually a sort of a system or a software or an online tool, you can say, which is used to overall manage and build a website. It's fairly easy to create a WordPress based website in a very non-technical way. If you are not from a technical background, if you have don't know the coding part, still you can go ahead and create a website. That's the beauty of WordPress, guys. And it's as easy, it's easy to go ahead and change things in your website, the way you change your Facebook status. So the way you upload images on your Facebook profile, you add the status update on your Facebook profile. That's how you can do similarly with a WordPress-based website. So all in all, you need a domain. If I talk about domain, I hope most of you know what exactly a domain stands for. A domain is something like I have dmpathshala.com. That's the URL. That's the domain which I have selected. Whenever we have to book a specific domain, let's say most of you have to book a certain domain by your name. Let's say if you have to look for manojsagar.com or priyanka.com, whatever, you have to first of all check for its availability, whether it's there or not. One of the great website to buy in domain, guys, is godaddy.com. All right. And other one which I would tell you, if in case you want to buy .in domain and that too at a cheaper price, I would tell you a link from where you can actually get that, which is, just give me a moment, I'll let you know. If you want much cheaper domain, what is the procedure to get that? All right, so I'm just going to give you the link and... Right. Okay, somehow that link has got expired. Just a sec. Are we clear up till now, the kind of things which I have mentioned so far? So, all right, so guys, also just want to let you know the lessons part, which I have mentioned right now, that's available again only for the paid subscribers, all those who are, who have subscribed to the DMP course, only they can actually see that. So their account gets valid. So if I go further down on the DMP course list and you want to buy a domain. Yes, Rahul, please go ahead and ask your question. So what you need to do, I have done O-level software. So O-level software of what exactly, Rahul? Okay, from Doik, okay. But this is very different to digital marketing and graduation, okay. So this is a very specific, your personal question. So I can definitely take that after the class, Rahul. Sure. Feel free to connect with me on WhatsApp. So guys, whatever personal questions you have in terms of your career related thing, definitely you can surely talk to me on WhatsApp. So I'm sharing across the URL, guys, from where you can go ahead and buy a cheap domain. But since you are part, all those who are part of Digital Marketing Pathshala, I'm giving them free website also, free domain, free hosting, and I'm getting them free overall WordPress stuff. So I'm letting you know what is the procedure like. Go ahead and click on this specific crazy domain one, okay? From crazy domains, the URL which I've created, which I've shared with you, you can click on that specific, because that specific, crazy domain banner, click on that, get an account created, and the .in domains which you would get over here are for as cheap as 99 rupees. So this is the major one of the great ways to get a free lesser domains for lesser price. And let's say I have an account of crazy domains. I would go ahead and book a domain right now in front of you. Whose domain should I go ahead and book? Okay, I have to book it for Manu. Manu, welcome to the session today. Can you hear me, Manu? So let's say if I have to book a domain for Manu, what I would do, I would first of all check for its availability. Let's say I do it. ManuSharma.in, that's the way you first of all go ahead and check for. Most of you would be knowing whatever stuff I'm talking about, so please bear with me in case you already know, since not everybody is aware about it, right? So I have typed in the URL ManuSharma.in, so it's perfectly available. I would go ahead and I can add that across. I can add that across into my shopping cart. And simply I can go ahead and then register now. So you just see what I did just now. First of all, I went to the same URL which I had given you for booking the domain, which was of the crazy domain. So don't go to the crazydomains.com directly. The URL which I gave you earlier on, you have to go through that. In case you would go through that, then only you would get it for 99 rupees. You would have to create an account. Once you have created an account on Crazy Domain, search for the domain name which you want. If it's available, go ahead and register it. So let's say I register it. I have got that for a year. It's for $2.04 a year. I would go ahead and click on checkout. I would pay for it and get that done. So Manu, should I book that domain for you? So let me show you how to get that booked, domain booked. I would go ahead and click on continue order. Continue order again. And then continue order. So that's it. I'm not looking for other stuff. And once I'm done with this, I'm going ahead and paying for it. So I have a PayPal. You can simply pay with the help of your domain, debit or a credit card also. Okay. I go ahead and log in. All right. So I'm just going to pay for it and then going to show you how to go ahead and configure this. So I'm paying through my PayPal account, guys. It's not necessary that you should also have a PayPal account. What I'm trying to say that you need to pay either from your debit card or credit card. But if you are going to be a DMP, if you are a DMP student, then you don't need to pay for that. I am going to get that thing done for you. Right. So now what has happened, the overall domain, the domain which you have booked, which you have bought has got booked. It will come into action. Absolutely right, Dhruv, GoDaddy and Big Fix. Absolutely, there are plenty of others which are bigger ones, but I wanted to let you know a way through which you can buy it at a cheaper price. Absolutely, GoDaddy is best. There is no doubt about it. GoDaddy is the best, but the way I was telling you, you can even buy it from here in case you want it at a cheaper price. GoDaddy sometimes don't give you, sometimes they give you for at a cheaper price, sometimes they don't. So I was telling you the mechanism of getting it at a cheaper price because I have got a specific, tie-up with Crazy Domain, and my tie-up with Crazy Domain only works if you would go to Digital Marketing Pathshala's link, which I have given to you. Click on the Crazy Domain banner and the link which will come up. Sign up over there and then you can get to get the .in domain for 99 rupees. All right. So, okay. Right now it says pending. So it's going to take some time, guys, to. Okay, so it's going to take 24 hours to get it processed, guys, right? So how much time it takes? It takes 24 hours maximum. It can happen after an hour also. Maximum is 24 hours. Once that gets done, guys, I'm letting you know what is the next thing which needs to do. Now I have the hosting server. You can buy hosting if you're doing it by yourself. You can take hosting from Airwire as well. Otherwise, I have a hosting server, and what you need to change is the name servers. The name servers which you see over here are of the same server which Crazy Domain owns. From whichever place you would buy hosting services, you have to take their DNS, their domain name server. DNS stands for domain name servers. You have to ask your hosting provider for DNS. They would provide you DNS service, DNS settings, and you would have to enter that. You would just have to enter it over here. So .NET, .org are not DNS. Great question, Shubham. These are .NET, .org, .in or .co.in or .com. They all are TLDs. Okay, so guys, there would be a few things which are new for you. These are TLDs like .com, .co.in, .in. TLDs. TLD stands for top level domain. All right. So TLDs are these .NET, .org, .in, and DNS is domain name server settings. Okay. So domain name server settings is DNS, and these are DNS are provided by your hosting provider. Okay. So once you have bought the domain, then you have to align it with a hosting server. Because domain तो आपने ले लिया, अब आपकी जो वेबसाइट की फाइल्स होंगी, the files which you are going to keep on your website has to kept somewhere. It will be virtually kept somewhere in a server which is going to be somewhere outside in US or India, wherever your server is. The server I have, that is a US server. I have my hosting server which I offer to all my what do you say, DMP students. So what I would do, I have my domain name server as ns1.internet.co.in. Hosting packages.com. So I know that because I am a hosting seller, right? NS1 and NS2. NS2 and NS2 internet hosting packages. So you don't need to be worried about what exactly is it going to be at your case, how much it cost. See, generally domain the hosting starts with somewhere close to 1500, 2000 rupees per annum. But if you are a DMP student, then it's going to be free from my side. So a domain name somewhere close to I book it for 100. Otherwise, it might fetch you for 500. So almost close to your domain name, server, your server, and also your domain, which will cost somewhere close to 3,000 rupees. I'm going to make it part of your overall course. So 3,000 rupees I'm going to invest out of the 7,500 which I'm taking from you, plus also 30,000 rupees worth of Google AdWords coupon. Also, I give it across free to my students. All right. Along with that, I also provide certifications, which is Google AdWords, Google Analytics, and Bing Ad certifications, along with Google Mobile Advertisement, Google Shopping. All in all, six certificates from Google and Bing directly. So they're not going to be provided by any other body but Google themselves, since we are Google authorized learning partner. All right. So that's the way DMP is actually different from other institutions. All right. So once I have done that, let me show you an example of a existing. Let me see if I have an account which I can show you this. This is taking time for Manu Sharma one. Okay, for Santosh accounts, Guru Prasad, I've already done for all these. Okay, so let me take it for, I want to take a particular domain for which I can show you right from the beginning. Okay, I would do it for Guru Prasad's. I'm showing you for one of the account. how will I clear the certification exam? Whatever stuff which you would get to learn from here, Rahul, you would get to clear that. So I would tell you each and everything how to get the certification exam. Initially, we provide you from our end, and then later on, we also let you know how to clear at your end also. So both the things happen. We give you from our end, and then you get it done from your end also. Couple of times it happens. You can see the name servers right up here. I have already changed them. I have got them. This is my website, Internet Hosting Packages, which provides hosting services. So I'm a reseller of hostgator.com. All right. So if I go to hostgator.com, that is the number one website for hosting services. So like you have GoDaddy, which is number one for providing domains. You have HostGator, which is number one in terms of providing hosting services. And their monthly charges somewhere starts close to $4 a month, which is the minimum, right? So even it starts at $13 also, but the most minimum one is $4 only if you buy it for 3 years. So if you see it somewhere comes close to, $40-$50, which is 2,500, 3,000 rupees, right? Yes, Guru, you are late. It's 3:28, right? So, like I was telling you, this particular website, Internet Hosting Packages, is mine, where we try to give, from where we give you the hosting services. You would have to, once you have booked the domain, you would go into name servers, and you can see the modify button. You would click on modify, and then you would enter ns1.internethostingpackages.com and ns2. These are two hosting DNS which I provide. I'm just letting you know for your information, guys, because all these things are going to be done by me, right? Once that is being done, the hosting DNS is being entered across for your domain. What you would do, you would get a cPanel from my side, okay? The cPanel which you get is going to be like this. All right, so that's the cPanel. What you would get is the username and a password from my side. I'm just going to check for that. Just give me a moment. So we have Manu, is it your first time in today's session? And Tajinder, are you also joining in for the very first time? So you can, I would give you the... Okay. Okay, Manu, that's your second time. All right, Tejinder, how about you? Are you attending for the first time, Tejinder? What would be the server specification? Okay, so Manu, what I have done, I have already mentioned the server specifications first time. Okay, I have mentioned the server specifications in the crazy domain panel from where I have bought the domain in the name server setting. And this was the server specifications. Okay, when you say server specification, Andy, which I would give you, it's going to be 500 MB data space and 1 GB bandwidth, so which I'm going to provide you. So 1 GB bandwidth is the maximum which I provide you, and 500 MB disk space, which is more than enough for a mini website, at least, I would say, at least up to 50, 60 pages, you can actually take that. So bandwidth means RAM. No, bandwidth means number of people who can come onto your site on a monthly basis. So people who would download stuff from your website is going to be, so traffic capacity, absolutely. Traffic capacity, how many people come onto your site? More and more people come onto your website, the bandwidth gets consumed. So 1 GB is more than enough if you're looking at doing it for the first time. Right, so I would give you the cPanel, guys. Once you would log into your cPanel, I would give you the URL and also the password. All right, what you would do, you would go ahead and first of all install the WordPress. Okay. I have already done it for most of you. For Dhruv, I believe I've given your website, Guru's website. Manoj, you've got the website. Nitin, you've got the website. Santosh, you've got the website. And others will also get the website when they would actually be part of it, right? So once you get the website, I've already done the installation part of the WordPress. What I had done for installing WordPress, guys, okay, Dhruv, I would give it to you. All right. So for installing your website, for installing WordPress on your website, you would have to first of all log into your cPanel. I will give you the username and password. Scroll further down. Don't access the files, the database, the domain. You can create email accounts from here. All right. So email accounts can be created. Plus, for installing WordPress, you can go to software and then quick install. Click on quick install, guys. It will ask you what do you want to install. I have already installed WordPress over here, so that's why I'm not going to install it again, but I'm letting you know how do you get that installed. All right, so you can see a lot of CMS which are mentioned over here. You can go ahead and install whichever sort of CMS you want to install. So Santosh, I didn't get this kind of window when I opened my admin. Absolutely, because Santosh, the admin which you had opened, which you had logged in, was the WordPress. At present, what I am letting you know, we are at the cPanel of your server. After going on to the cPanel of your server, we go to the quick install, and with the quick install, we go ahead and click on installing WordPress. After you have installed the WordPress, then that thing which will come is the same thing which you have seen. So I'm going to come on to that part. So that's a step prior to what you have seen so far. That's the overall stuff which I've already got that done from you, and you have seen, you have not been part of this exercise since I did that for you, right? But I'm letting you know for your overall knowledge sake. What I would do in this case, I would go ahead and click on install WordPress and get that installed. I've already done that for this particular domain, which is Guru Prasad Hegde, right? So I would go ahead and click on install. So this was a very simple task which was being done. In case you want to do it at your end, I can help you. You can ping me across. I can help you to do that in case you have further more questions. Once that's being done, this particular tool, Quick Install, will give you your WordPress username and WordPress password, right? So your WordPress username and password would be given across. So I would open the overall WP admin, which is the backend of your website. Once you have installed the WordPress, it will give you the username and password of your WordPress platform of your website. Okay. You would get it in this fashion, right, Santosh? That's what you would have seen. It gives you a username and password to enter. It will give you the login. Once you have done the quick install, it would give you the login URL and then the username and password. Go ahead and enter that. Okay, just a sec. The wrong password. Now what happens, my entire backend of my website comes over here. My domain was being bought by me. Then by changing the DNS settings, I have got the hosting configured. Your DNS settings only get worked upon when you have bought the hosting. But I would be providing you your hosting at free, as in your domain would be free from my side, your hosting would be free from my side. I would get the cPanel up for you. I would also get the WordPress panel up for you if you want, right? So I'm just still trying to tell you how the overall things work in the background to get your website up. So any questions or doubts, there might be certain doubts, so please go ahead and ask me wherever you have felt that it was a bit confusing for you. So validity of this domain is 1 year, Nathan. Yeah. So can you give cPanel details? Absolutely, Santosh. I would give you the cPanel details. Yes. And Guru Prasad, I would also give you the cPanel details. All right. Anybody else who has got a question? So Dhruv, Guru, Priyanka, Manu, Manoj, Nitin, Omkar, Prince, Rahul, Santosh, Shubham, Sid, Tejinder. Okay, no questions. Let me know with a yes or a no. Dhruv says no questions. Manu says okay. So do feel to refer to this video again. It will be renewed, absolutely. But I give it free for the first time, Rahul, when you become a DMP student. So it's valid for 1 year. All right. So guys, that's the panel, which looks like, okay, now the major work comes over here. You know, most of the stuff which I have shown you so far is being done by me only. All right. And you can go ahead. C panels is yours. Yeah, the major C panel is mine, but I would give you C panel of your website also. Sure, Onkar, I would help you. We would definitely have sessions on AdSense also, and I would let you know about that as well. Right. So, like I was telling you, with the WordPress based panel, this is your back end of your website. If I show you the front end, that's how it's going to look like. So this is the front end, which comes by default, you know. Okay, no problem, Guru. So this is the front end of your how to create your own cPanel. See, your how to create your own cPanel, you need a hosting provider, Tejinder. So in case you want to do it yourself, then you would have to buy hosting from any of these places, whether Hostgator. Hostgator is the most perfect one, in my opinion. GoDaddy is good with the domain. I would recommend them for the domain part. But if you if you want to talk about the hosting part, Hostgator is number one. They have zero tolerance ratio. They have zero downtime. So I always recommend Hostgator, right? So once you buy that, then you connect your hosting services domain name server, which is DNS, to your domain. Once that's being done, you get the cPanel up, all right? You get the cPanel, and within the cPanel, you can go into the quick install button and get installed the WordPress, which is a simple job. It's called Hostgator, I'll tell you, hostgator.com. That's number one in terms of, over here you can see, this is the one. You would see a lot of advertisement by these guys. They are number one in terms of hosting. All right, so once that's being done, By default, your website is going to look in the front end like this. Okay, so once your website looks like this, you would need to change the overall way it looks like. I would give you a certain theme which you can which would be uploaded by me, and you can go ahead and edit that. And the theme looks like, so Santosh, I forgot your URL. All right, so Santosh, even your website needs the uploading of the theme. Okay, I'll do that. So the kind of theme which I give guys is something like this. Your website would look like this. It's going to be a personal website where you would see, this is for one of my student who had actually edited the overall website when I had given her the theme. She made changes to her website. So the homepage, the about us page, the skill sets, experience, education, portfolio, reference, overall, these things are being mentioned right up over here. Right, you can see the skills section, the work experience, the education part, portfolio she didn't change, otherwise you can change the portfolio part, and this is the overall references section, and then you have the contact details, right, and you can embed your overall Google Maps and your social media icons. In case you're looking for something different kind of a theme, guys, there's another website from which you can buy a theme. Now, this particular theme costs somewhere close to $58, I believe. which is almost close to 3,000 or 4,000 rupees, I would give you free this particular theme also for free. So all in all, your website cost is similar to what I charge for the entire course. So Dhruv says, sir, can you please provide me a list of website which you already have? Okay, sure, Dhruv, I would provide you. I have plenty of websites, so I can provide you the list. All right. So in case you're looking for a very specific website, guys, not a personal portfolio kind, and you're ready to invest, then you can go to this website to check for certain themes. And that is themeforest.net. Once you go to themeforest.net, you can click on WordPress. All right. Click on WordPress. And within this, let's say I'm giving you an example. You're looking at building a website, which is for, let's say, own a gym. Okay. You want to build a website which is for a gym. Then you can see certain templates which these guys offer you. When I say templates, these are already made stuff. All you have to do is get these templates, buy these templates, get them uploaded onto your site. I'll tell you how to do that. And go ahead and change content as per you. They will already have certain content, certain dummy content, which might not suit you, but you can simply go ahead and remove their content and have your content up there. Editing part can be done. So let's say this is the very first template I'm showcasing you. So that's one of the example which I have taken. So it's opening up. What I did, I clicked on the live preview button, right? So when I was over here, I clicked on the live preview button. And when I clicked on the live preview, it's opening up. You can see this is a perfect made website. You know, your website is going to look like this. You know, you would have a blog section, you would have the trainer section, you would have the schedule section, the about us page, and any other pages. So you can make changes to it. You can do edit in the logo. You can have your logo up right up here. You can have a picture the way you want. You can have a different picture altogether. You can have different content being coming across on the slide over here. Similarly, if you go further down, you can have whatever kind of pictures you want to have, whatever content you want to have. You can simply go ahead and edit as per your convenience, right? So you can see this is a lot of dummy content. These images are free. Absolutely, these images are free, as in, I mean, they come along with the theme. So you are definitely allowed to use them. It's grow need. Absolutely, you don't need a web developer. Absolutely. For a good number of pages, you don't need a developer. Till the time you need very specific, functionality, you don't need a developer. So after purchasing theme, you would have to go ahead and upload that. So I'll show you how to do that. So Shutterstock is a free image provider. Absolutely, it is. Yeah. So you can buy, you can get themes, you can get pictures from there. So Pixabay also, absolutely, Shubham. That's right. Flickr. Yes. Flickr is a place where everybody uploads their picture on their own, right? Just like you have Pinterest and you have Instagram. So, right, guys, so this is one of the theme showcasing you another example. Let's say you want an e-commerce theme, e-commerce website, okay? When I say, let's say I need an e-commerce based website, I would click. So what I did on themeforest.net, I had clicked on WordPress, and after clicking on WordPress, I had submitted e-commerce in the search bar. When I go further down, I mean there are plenty of options. So let's say I'm just trying to see which one. You can even decide on the basis of ratings, guys. You can see this specific theme has got 136 ratings. 1,092 people have bought it. So I am expecting this one to be a much better one. So let's try and open this. Okay. So I have opened this specific e-commerce. Okay. And you know what? The best part about these theme, guys, is that these are responsive websites. These are responsive themes. They open very well on a laptop, on a desktop, and on a mobile. Just to give you an example of one of my website, which is, even if you would open my website, all of my websites which are there, they all are responsive websites. You know, they would open perfectly. I would tell you how the responsive thing, what is a responsive and what is a non-responsive thing is like, guys. Very first thing is definitely your website would open properly on mobile, tablet, Android, or an Apple operating system for sure. There would not be any cut, or there you don't have to zoom in. It would adjust absolutely. That's what, like Guru Prasad mentioned. You let's say if I go scroll further down, you can see my picture right up here and my skill sets and all. There is a certain font size. If I would skew this, okay, what I'm doing, you can see I skewed it. You can see the overall change in the website. When there's no, it would adjust automatically on its own. There would be no cutting across of the words or the pictures, right? The picture got smaller automatically. If I keep adjusting it, the picture is getting smaller automatically on its own, right? It is bigger in size now. That's what is called responsiveness, guys. So now look at this. Picture is this much big. The overall text font, the text size, font size also gets smaller. The picture size keeps getting smaller. This is becoming so much responsive. Nothing is getting broken up across, right? So sure, Onkar, I would take that question of yours after the session, definitely. And you can check responsiveness of a website, absolutely, like Rahul has mentioned, on responsivedesignchecker.com. Absolutely, guys. So this is one of the tool through which you can see whether your website is responsive for iPad, for a 11-inch MacBook Air, for a 15-inch, for a 17-inch, for a 27-inch monitor. Absolutely. For Your Creations also, I would show you even my website, yourcreations.ca, is a responsive based website. And these responsive websites are the in thing today. I mean, you cannot live in the digital world till the time you don't have a responsive based website, right? So if I skew this, you would see, right? So the picture size, see the font size keep decreasing, the image size keep decreasing, right? That's what responsiveness is, guys, right? You can see mobile oriented PPC campaigns, text keeps getting smaller, keeps getting bigger. That's my website, guys, of my agency. This is the responsiveness, right? And like this particular tool, responsivedesignchecker.com, helps you to see whether your website, you can enter your website address, click on the go button and select for whichever site, right? Let me show you this way. It takes a lot of effort to make a website responsive, but the beauty of these themes is that they are already responsive in nature, right? So that's how my website looks like in an iPad, right? There's no, I mean, there's nothing which is getting cut across. If I want to check on 11-inch MacBook, it looks like this, 15-inch, 17-inch, 27-inch. It's looking perfectly fine, right? An iPad portrait, Nexus 7 landscape, it's all perfectly fine, right? So that's with the responsiveness, guys, and you can simply go ahead and look for themes. I was telling you about the e-commerce website theme. This was one of the website theme which I had looked at. I can go ahead and simply click on live preview. In case you are looking at a very specific website, guys, an e-commerce based website, I've got certain themes for e-commerce websites also. I can give you that as well if you are a DMP student for free. All right. So I've got a pet related theme also. I've got many themes, paid themes with me. I can simply give that to you if you are part of DMP, right? So if you scroll further down, you can see this is an e-commerce based website template where you can go ahead and add to cart, you can put your products and simply get your website made up, right? So there are plenty of websites which I have made using these themes only. So for e-commerce, use Magento or WordPress. Both of them are good. But if you're looking at building a much, much bigger website, then Magento is the much better one. So do you have education? Absolutely, Nathan. I do have. I would give you that. You can surely remind me. I would send you across that. So since Nathan is part of DPS, so I would give you that. So can we edit color? Absolutely. Manu, you can edit whatever things you need. Even the color combination, you can edit that across. All right. So what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to take a specific WordPress backend, so which is of Guru Prasad, and I'm going to upload a specific theme I have. All right. So in order to, once I have downloaded, let's say I have bought a theme, I have downloaded the theme from ThemeForest. Okay, where is the edit option for color combination? It's in the CSS. It's also there when you go into the appearance section and in the themes part. Absolutely, which Shum said. In appearance, you have the themes part. All right, so what I'm doing right now, when I go to the appearance and then the themes, I can go ahead and upload a specific theme I want. So Guru Prasad says some may give option to change color and some may not. Yes, the ones which would not give you option, Guru, over there, then you would need help of a designer to who knows CSS, how to change across CSS of the website. By going onto the styling sheets, that can be edited. All right, so what I have done, guys, after I have got the WordPress backend, I go into the appearance section, and after appearance, I go into the theme section. Within the themes, I would go ahead and click on add new. All right, there are certain themes which are available for free also, but the free themes never ever work perfectly, guys. So I will never ever recommend you. You can get the free themes also up. So I've got the paid theme. I would click on add new. Okay, and then it's asking me for choose a file. I have got the file with me. So I've already got that downloaded. So you might have to download it if you're doing it yourself. You can see the kind of themes I have. I have blog related themes. I've got corporate themes. I've got e-commerce themes. I've got education related themes. I've got hosting packages kind of themes. I've got pet websites related themes, small businesses, support forum related themes. I mean, a lot of many themes I have got. These are just some of the examples, guys. So I go into my resume related themes. All right, I've got this theme in a zip folder. I would go ahead and click on the zip folder and click on open and then go ahead and click on install. So it's going to take some time. It's close to 20%, 21%. All right, so it's 50%. It's taking a bit of time. Absolutely, the zip file has to be taken. Yeah. So how these guys actually give you the overall theme is in a zip folder. So you have to upload the zip file. Because many files are there, right? Absolutely. So that's why they give you in the zip folder. So now you can see it has been installed. What I have to do is now, next thing is to go ahead and click on activate. So in a very simple fashion, you are creating a website in a very non-technical fashion. Now it's saying go ahead and get certain plugins. So there are three plugins which needs to be uploaded. So Prince says means get a domain, purchase a theme, upload it on WordPress, and edit accordingly. Okay. It's like Prince, get a domain, then get a hosting. After getting a hosting, get the hosting and the domain linked up first with the help of that domain name server. That's number three. Number four, log into the cPanel. And number five, being install the WordPress. Right? After installing the WordPress, number six is to install the theme. Buy the theme and then install the theme. The hosting specification, sorry, what's your question, Tejinder? The hosting which I'm providing, it's 500 MB space and 1 GB bandwidth which I provide. Right, so you can go ahead. Now, the next thing is to install these plugins. Begin installing plugins. Absolutely, it's a Linux server. Yeah, it is. So, yeah, that's right. 500 MB space and 1 GB bandwidth. So what I'm doing, I'm clicking on install for all these plugin guys. You have to install the plugins which it mentions. If you want to exceed it, then I can let you know the pricing for that. But it's like much more than sufficient if you're trying to get a new website up till the time you don't promote it. The 1 GB bandwidth is more than enough. So please show me where you got the plugins. It automatically, when we had uploaded the theme of Santosh, then after uploading, it asked me to activate. I clicked on the activate button, and after clicking the activate, there was a link. It said install the plugins. I clicked on that button. It said install the plugins. These three plugins came in, and I started activating it. Right? You can refer to the recording of the session, but I'm letting you know that's the way it is. After I have installed all three of them, then I have to activate all three of them one by one. All right, so activated one, activated two. Absolutely, we can see the plugins also on the left-hand side corner. Absolutely right. So I have activated all three of them. Okay, once that's being done, I have to import the overall dummy content of the site, and there are different ways for every different theme. For this particular theme, the way you upload a dummy content is going onto the left-hand side, click on Follics, and underneath Follics you have Import Demo. Okay, Santosh, I'll tell you what are plugins. So click on Follics and click on Import Demo, which is the demo content will come in, and then click on Import. I'm telling you in a while, Santosh, show. So this is happening. Okay, some files have not got imported. Most of the files have got imported, some have not. Let me check how the website looks like on the front end. Seems there is some problem with the theme. I would get that fixed up. Okay, so plugins, Santosh, are extra functionalities. So let's say if there are you're looking at a contact us form, and that theme doesn't carry a contact us thing. You're looking at some other functionalities. Plugins are just like add-ons. They act as an add-on functionalities, right? So most of the stuff is here. Some pictures I have not got imported. I would get the new theme up. All right. So, but let me tell you, this is how it looks like, guys. The overall dummy content is over here with the reference one. You have the reference. Okay, I had another question by Rahul. I will say so, but mostly why people not prefer? Mostly people prefer WordPress. If you will see which is the most, what do you say, popular CMS, it's WordPress. No other CMS is that popular as a WordPress. WordPress is the most preferred one. So you can see the overall dummy content is right up here, guys, for the references, for the education part. If I have to edit that, how would I do? How would I do that? I'll show you the experience part. All right. Then you have the skills part. Okay, certain things have not got imported, but still I'll tell you. And now I would go on to the backend part, the backend of my website. All right, we can change the content on the theme. Absolutely, that's what I'm telling you. If you will go, let's say, to the education part on the left-hand side, you go to education. All right, after going into education, you go ahead and click on edit part. So you can see the content which was right there on the front end. So Manu says after domain. What exactly you mean by after domain? Are you asking me to repeat the entire thing? We need hosting server. Absolutely, you need a hosting server. So if you're going to be part of the DMP, then I will give you everything for free within that. So you can see this is the front end, guys. And over here you can see it says master design, master degree of design, and blah 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 and blah. I can go ahead and change that at the back end, I would say. Let's say I write it Master of Accountancy. this is just a dummy thing which I'm trying to tell you. University of Bangalore, I go ahead and update that. All right. You can see I have clicked on update. Once I click on update, now I would go to the front end and I would do a refresh. Can you see the same thing which I had edited comes up over here? Similarly, I can change not just this thing, but each and every part of my website. So that's the education stuff. You can see I can edit the overall timing part also. So instead of September 2014, let's say I do it 2012. I mentioned that I can update that, can add more. Absolutely, you can add as many. You can see the add more section over here. So you have the experience part, references part. Let's say I go into the references part and click on references. So for every theme, it's a different thing. Every theme will come with a tutorial, guys, with a tutorial on how to import the dummy content and how to edit that. And they're very much self-explanatory. But I'm still making you walk through the entire WordPress panel, right? So let's say I go ahead and edit one of the references, which is the Anna Miller one, okay? Can increase tab or menu. Absolutely, you can do all that. So the Anna Miller one, if you see on the front end, the references part, about us and all our plugins. See, some are plugins and some are not. So you don't need to be really worried about what are plugins and what are already coming with the theme. Most of the basic functionalities come along with the theme in itself. If you're trying to add something new to the overall website, then the plugins would be there. What all kind of plugins you should download, I would keep instructing you. All right. So with your theme, Anna Miller, like I was telling you, this one, if I, let's say, change that, I change it to my name. Whatever. So I go ahead and update it. So from Anna Miller, it has turned to my name, Nick Batla. I go ahead and refresh that. So I refresh. So it's very important to every time you make a change, you click on update. When you go ahead and see on the front end, you would have to refresh it. All right, so now I go further down and within the references section, you can see my name being over there, right? That is as simple as, like I said, changing your Facebook account, guys, right? So that's what I have to tell you. Every website theme has a different way to get edited across. All right. Any language options? Absolutely. There are language options also. So if you are looking for that, I think that's part of settings. I have not created any further. So in the general settings, you can actually, yeah, the Hindi themes are there. Hindi content you can place across. So within the settings part, you can actually change that. You can see the language part, right? So Hindi. Not really sure whether this theme actually supports Hindi or not. No, so different theme would have to be seen, it would have to be checked where Hindi is actually enabled. So it's pretty simple. You can just go ahead and look for themes with the, what do you say? The Hindi option being available. So where will you put update meta tag? So Rahul Rai, meta tag definitely we will take, but that's overall part of the SEO campaign, SEO stuff which we'll cover. That is definitely going to be covered in our upcoming classes, right? So meta tags are definitely covered. All right, guys. So that's with the changing of the overall WordPress website. I hope it's pretty clear. Or I would, whatever website I have given you, so Nitin, I've given you your website and all those who, Saurabh, I've given you, along with your website credentials, I've given you certain PDF documents or an HTML file where all the details are mentioned, how you can edit your website. I would recommend you to please use the information which I have given you just now in terms of editing stuff, along with use that with the file which I have given you. Read that file and get the things updated on your website. So Tejinder says we create in English and then change language. No, you created right from the beginning in that same language, Tejinder. You cannot change it. It would never ever convert it. So Santosh says, please send the theme. Absolutely. I have to send the theme to you and Guru Prasad both. I'm going to do that very shortly. So doesn't say in my website, plugins like About Us, Contact Us, etc. are not coming. You don't see this particular About Us and Contact Us all over there? No, it's already there, Nitin. Just check it properly. If you still feel that they are not there, I have configured it myself. And I remember it's very much there. Yes. Okay. That cannot be, Guru. That cannot be because by default it's mine. So you can create new accounts. You can create new accounts which can be there. All right. So Nitin, do have a look again. I know very well that your About Us section and overall sections were very much there. All right. So. Yes, you have. Right. Now you say that. Okay. So are we all okay with WordPress? Whatever questions you will have at a later stage, you can feel free to ask me. I would send you the theme for sure, Guru and Santosh. And you can take it from there. Manoj, your website is also up there. So you can go ahead and change that as well. Right, Manoj? So what's embedding? All right. Embedding is like if you have certain thing. Let's say, I would tell you certain plugins which are very important in terms of having on a website. It's not reflecting. Okay, Nitin, I will open your panel after the class and I will let you know. I don't think anybody has edited their website yet. Right. So what embedding is, let's say there is content somewhere on a different website altogether. Okay. And I want to get that embedded onto my website. The way you can see for digital marketing Pathshala, what I have done, I've embedded a YouTube video and I've embedded a slideshare presentation. Okay. What embedding is, okay, I am logged in right now. Okay, so what you can see in this specific URL, you can see a SlideShare presentation which is embedded over here. When I say embedded, because it's hosted on SlideShare network. It's hosted on SlideShare network, but it's getting showcased across on my website. Similarly, this particular video, you can see the YouTube icon being there, which means that the video is right up there on the YouTube channel, but it's getting embedded over here. How I did that, I'll show you how I did that with the help of, so it is kind of getting or giving backlink to other or to our or other sites. No, it's not a backlink, I would say. If somebody would click on YouTube or SlideShare, yes, to some extent, because we are not doing it intentionally. We are embedding it, but embedding does help in backlink. Absolutely, the hyperlink happens. You're right. So how I did that, guys, I got that done with the help of certain plugins only. If I open the same website, the backend of the same website, let's say, and I try to embed something. Let's say, first of all, I have to get a specific plugin for that. To get the embedding thing done, I would go into plugin, click on add new, and get a SlideShare plugin. So let's say if I have to get a YouTube video embedded or a SlideShare embedded, let's say I do it for YouTube. All right. I would type what I did on the left hand side, I went to the plugin section. Okay, I went to plugin section, and after clicking on plugin, I clicked on add new. After clicking on add new, this particular screen came up. I typed on YouTube embed and press enter. I pressed enter. All right. So you can see there are plenty of plugins which are available over here. Any one of them would actually work perfectly. And I would click on YouTube embed, let's say the very first one. So now I would go, after clicking on install, now I would go ahead and click on activate plugin. You can see the plugin got activated. Now what I would do, let's say I am creating a new page altogether on my website. Okay, this is the YouTube one. I can see for the options part also. Okay, so I'm not going to make you confused by going on to all these things. I'm going on to the pages part, or the post. Let's say the post. I create a new blog post on my website, and in the new post, I want to embed a certain video. So let's say I type in YouTube video embed test. That's the page name which I'm giving it. All right, I go further down. And within this page, the video embed, just a sec. Okay, so I think it's going to take the short codes. It hasn't come yet. Just let me go to YouTube first and take the embed code from there. So now what I would do, I would go to youtube.com, and let's say just a minute. So I go into youtube.com, I select a specific video. Okay, let's say this is the video which I want to embed. All right. Or maybe this one. I would open this video, and within the video, underneath the video, you would see a button saying share. All right. Click on the share button, and it would give you an embed option. So I'll repeat once again. You got the video open on YouTube. You go onto the share button, click on share, and then you have the share button, then the embed, and then the email. Click on the embed section. It gives you the embed code overall. Do control A, select the overall code, and do control C. You have copied the entire embed code. Go back to your website and paste your overall code. When you see the Folix shortcode, you over here, you can see that same thing, which is the YouTube embed section. You click on the YouTube embed, and it says insert video URL. Okay, I can just submit the video URL over here. I don't need the even embed code. I go ahead and okay, I have a question from Tejinder. Purchase one theme, then use it with other web assist. If yes, then how? I'm sorry. Can you be a bit more descriptive on your question, Tejinder? Is that a question or a statement you're saying? Please type your question in full if you can. I'm unable to understand. Purchase one theme, and so what is the question like? So, I'm posting the YouTube URL over here. Okay, it's not taking, just a second. All right, so I have posted the YouTube, instead of embed code, I have posted the URL. Let's see how this happens. I'm going ahead and clicking on publish. When I go ahead and click on publish, and I go ahead and click on view post. I'm looking at the post in a new tab. All right. Somehow the video isn't there. The embedding thing didn't happen, just a sec. Let me try the other way. So how many times we can use a single theme? I hope he's asking that. We can use it multiple times. It's perfectly fine. Please click on update. Which update do you mean to say? I did click on update. Yes, I did that. I clicked on the update part and I am going ahead and refreshing it once more. Let's see. Was it the update which was not being done perfectly? Somehow this particular plugin didn't took it. Let me try the other way. So I'm trying it a couple of different ways. So please click on update on WordPress. Yes, I did that. So let me now refresh the page and see whether the video comes up. Yes, the video has come up. The way video has come up is by posting the video content just like that, the embed code. All right, so I'm updating it again. All right, so guys, what I did, instead of taking you help of the YouTube embed plugin, I just simply went to the YouTube video, took the embed code from there by clicking on share and then embed. I took the entire embed code. I went to my website. I clicked on a new post, a new page or a post. In the new post, I simply pasted that same embed code. I didn't take any help from any of the tags here. I embedded this code and I simply clicked on update. I updated the page, and when I updated the page, I opened this page. I opened this post in a new tab. You can see view post. When I clicked on a new post, I refreshed it and the video came up over here. So you can actually embed video post on your website like these. Similarly, you can do it for SlideShare stuff also. So let's say if I go on to one of my SlideShare uploads. So today we are just focusing more on the WordPress thing only, guys. So Guru Prasad, what is the difference between embedding and adding URL? Okay, the adding of the URL didn't work. Embedding is the code gets embedded, and overall hosting, your overall video gets represented over there. If you're adding the URL, only the URL will get represented. Tejinder says, can we use one used theme while creating new? Absolutely, you can use that, Tejinder. You can do that. So let's say this is one of the slides. Let's say one of the slides which I'm going to see. There is an embed code over here for this also. I go on and the embed code. When I go to the edit part, sorry, it's in the share part. I'm so sorry. I'm just going back. When you have a particular slide share presentation, you go into the share button. Within the share button, you can see the embed code also being given to you over here with slide share. I go ahead and click on this. So Santosh says, you told something called body tag. Is it related to WordPress? So body tag is actually, for every web page, there is a body tag. For every web page, Santosh, there is a body tag. You have a header tag, you have a body tag for every web page. In a WordPress, absolutely also, whether it's whichever CMS it is, the body tag is there. You definitely have that part, a thing. And I believe you are asking because the remarketing code, which we had to submit, was before the within the body tag, right? So I'll give you the plugin also for the remarketing code, which you can place it across on your website, right? So I was first of all showing you the embed code which I've taken from SlideShare. I can go ahead and paste that across also. So I'm pasting that. Let's see what happens if this gets updated. Let me update that. Let's see without a plugin if it gets uploaded or not. Let's go ahead and refresh it. All right, so can you see the overall SlideShare stuff also got embedded over here, right? You have the video embed code. Can we learn remarketing things in classes? Absolutely. We would be, Rahul. Yes. We have done that in the last sessions also, and we would be doing. So there are plenty of things which we are going to learn. With DMP, everything about digital marketing we are learning. So we keep having classes, we keep learning in every session something or the other. So how much space will this take? Pretty good question. It will take 0 bytes on our website, but only the URL which is getting created, because the video which is getting embedded, let's say this video is of 5 GB. The video is hosted on the YouTube server, and the theme, let's say the SlideShare presentation, is of 1 GB. They both are not taking any space on our website, which is the best part. Yeah, so you don't need to be worried on that part, right? So the presentation, the video, similarly, other things can also be embedded. Let me show you with Facebook also. So within Facebook also, it will take a lot of time. It will take that as well. But within Facebook also, you have the embed code, guys, which you can embed it very easily. Yeah, Guru, that's right. We can save upon the space. Looking awesome. Yeah, it does. So you can simply, let's say, if I want to embed this specific post, guys, on my website, I can embed that also. And I could get the embed code. Just a sec. Let's say I would take a video which I want to embed. That would be the best example. So I go into the videos part, and let's say this is the video which I want to embed. And for embedding this video,
everyone, my name is Mike, and I'm from Digital Marketing.
I'm just looking at where the embed code they used to give it right now. I mean, right across there, and somehow the embed code is not coming. So Guru Prasad says, when we paste the video or website URL codes, Facebook is going to embedding automatically. Absolutely, whichever one. You have to just post that code in the overall page, and it will get embedded automatically. All right, so when I clicked on that pencil icon, it gives me the option of embed video, right? So I would go ahead and click on embed video. Can we embed our Facebook page? Absolutely, you can do that. And there are certain plugins for that also. So let's say if I want to embed this entire post, I would take the entire embed code. And I would go back to my website again. And let's say if I'm doing it underneath that, I'm hopeful it's going to take it, because sometimes Facebook works weirdly. They have something different all the time. So I have clicked on update, and let's try to refresh it and see how it works like. All right, somehow it has not taken it. Just a sec. We would probably need a Facebook plugin in this case, a Facebook embed plugin. So this is not getting embedded properly. Right, so maybe we would have to just a sec. On the left-hand side, we would have to either go ahead and add a certain plugin. Go into plugin section and then click on add new. Can you use Dropbox for this? Yes, you can do that, Tejinder. You can do that as well. If you have knowledge about that, you can embed things from Dropbox or from Google Drive also. So Facebook embed, right? So it says, so your Facebook more post can be embedded. Like someone did ask me this, I think it was Saurabh, and your photo albums can be embedded, your overall Facebook posts can be embedded. So let's say if we do it, the very first one, I would go ahead and click on activate plugin. And now I go into my same page, the post part, all posts, and click on the same post which I had created. And I go further down. Somehow that plugin is not getting visible here. All right. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to look for that same plugin, if that plugin should be over here. Okay, it's somehow not appearing. I would have to check it at my end and I would get let you know. The plugins, actually, the way we have the YouTube embed, let me just refresh this page again, that it then it might come up. All right, so if I go further down and see. Okay, guys, I would check for the much better plugins which can embed our Facebook. So there are a lot of plugins which are available. I would see one of them, each one of them, one after another, and then I'll let you know which one works the best. You can do some R&D at your end also, because plugins don't really work easily. You have to do that. So with the remarketing plugin, you would have to go to plugin again and add a new remarketing embed. Absolutely, yeah. So Google remarketing plugin has to be added on. So you can say it says include Google remarketing ad codes on upper page or post pages. This is also a spot for a default code. And this is another plugin. Let me tell you which one was going to work best. Right, so this one, I believe Google AdWords remarketing one. I would go ahead and install this one and activate this plugin. All right, once that's being done, on the left-hand side, you would get the option of the remarketing stuff. Within settings, when you go to the settings tab, you would see the Google AdWords remarketing tab. Click on that. Once you have installed that plugin, here, this is the place where you would post your AdWords remarketing code, guys. Right, Santosh? So if you remember, we had mentioned last time that you can take that remarketing code and get that posted across within the body tag. If you have a developer, then you can ask your developer to post it within the body. In case not, you can take that code and get that inserted here. Right, this was the one. And these plugins, most of them, Rahul, are free. You have the paid plugins also. There's no doubt about that. So all in all, I mean, there are a lot of plugins which are available. Some are free and some are not. Right? So, okay. And I think someone asked me, okay. So what is RSS? RSS is something group which was used earlier on. It's called real-time syndication, real-time simple syndication. And this was something which was used earlier on. They are discontinued. They were used earlier on, and they were used mostly for SEO purposes. So you don't need to pay attention to it. So I will and tell you. Okay. Right, guys. So that's about the overall getting your AdWords remarketing code also. Now I want to let you know, how do we get our website configured with Google AdWords, sorry, Google remarketing, and also just a sec, I'm trying for the last time for the Facebook tag, guys. So the Facebook embed. Okay, it says open a post or image on the Facebook, click on the date time, copy the URL, insert the following code in articles. Okay. You see, that's how it's gonna work. Let's see now, try it for the very last time. I'm gonna try it for the last time, guys. So it says copy the URL, overall URL, and insert the following code, and within that you have to have the URL. Let's try this for the last time, guys. And the URL was this, right? Or let's say if I try to do it, this specific URL. I go ahead and click on update. All right, let's see in the new post how this is gonna look like. Right, I go further down. Okay. Somehow it has not taken again. Okay, I forgot to have these things. Okay, just a sec. Bear with me for a minute, guys. What I'm doing, I'm trying to get the Facebook embed thing working. If this works this time, it's good. Otherwise, I'm gonna move ahead. So I have posted across the same thing. Click on update. All right, let's refresh the page once more and see it for the last time. Okay. All right, something has happened, but I would change the URL just a sec. Okay, it's probably gonna.
Hey everyone, my name is Mike.
I think now it's gonna work. Just give me a moment. It was not taking the overall page, it's taking only a specific post or a video or something. So maybe this time it's gonna work. All right, so I hope I'm not wasting a lot of time of yours, guys. So I'm just trying to help you if this thing is gonna work. The Facebook embed, I'm trying for the last time, doing a refresh. Thanks, Saurabh. All right. So, oh wow. See, this happened. The video, YouTube video is there, slide share was there, and now we are good with the Facebook embed also, right? The Facebook embed also happened, guys. So I am just going to let you know how this happened. What I had done, I had gone to the overall plugin section. I had selected one of the Facebook embed plugin. After, I hope that was clear to you. Okay, that's there's a video lag. All right. So we were able to do it, Guru. Everybody can see the video which is there up on Facebook that we have been able to, I mean, we got that embedded on our blog. So that's right across. So SlideShare, YouTube stuff, they all are right up here, right? They all got embedded. Right, guys? And the way it was being done, I had selected a specific plugin, which was Facebook Embed. When I clicked on that, when I got that uploaded, I went to the settings section. In the settings section, I had the Facebook Embed option. I clicked on that. Over there, the instructions were being mentioned. The instruction was mentioned that I have to take this specific code, which is within the these brackets. I copied that and I went to my page where I had to embed it. I pasted it over there. I pasted that code over there, and within that, the URL of the video was being also posted across, right? So I hope it's clear. If you want, I can still do that again for a newer post, guys. Let me know if that was clear to you or not. So if you want me to do it again, I can do it for a fresh piece of Facebook content, and I can show it to you. All right. So do you want me to do it again? It's all clear. Okay. Dhruv says, do it again. In URL, we need to copy the embed code. No, we don't need the embed code. That was the best part. So we don't need the embed code for this. So every plugin actually works in a different fashion. This plugin actually worked without an embed code. I would show you. Let's say I go into the same plugin again. All right. Let's say this time it's going to be a different, video altogether, which I'm going to upload. So yeah, I would do it again. Let's say I am going to this specific video. I open the video, okay? The video, URL which I get on the top, I have to take that. All right. Now I go back. I first of all go to the section which is underneath settings. Underneath settings, I got the Facebook embed option, settings, and then underneath setting there was the Facebook embed option. After getting that plugin installed, I went to settings and then Facebook embed. I clicked on that. After clicking, I got this code. These instructions were there. I copied this entire code, okay, which was there in the Facebook embed plugin. I copy this. I take that. I hope there is no video lag. That's why I'm going a bit slow, on a slower pace. I copy this. Okay. Now I have copied this. I go into the YouTube, the same page. Okay. On the back end of my WordPress website, I go to the page where things were mentioned. Let's say I, on a fresher note, I paste that code. Okay. Now when I paste that code, can you see the URL part? The URL part has to be edited, has to be replaced with the exact URL of the video which I want to embed. I'm not taking the embed code over here. I would now go to the Facebook page, copy the entire URL. So I go click on the website, the browser, do Control A and then Control C. I do that. Go back again to my WordPress page. Within that code, I would remove the URL symbol, URL wordings, edit, delete that, and replace it with the overall URL of my video. I have pasted the URL of my video which I wanted to embed, and now I would go ahead and click on update. Now once I click on update, guys, the page on the backend has got updated, and I would like to update the front end and see whether that new video has come up or not. So let's see that. So it's getting updated, and can you see the very YouTube video was there, the slide share thing was there, the first Facebook video was there. Now we have the second YouTube video also being part of it, right? We didn't take the Facebook video embed code. We just took the URL and got that embedded. Makes sense? Are we all clear on this part? All right. So yes says Dhruv, yes says Nitin, yes says Guru, yes says Saurav, yes says Santosh, yes says Tejinder. All right. So how about others? Rahul, Prince, Manoj, Manu. Are you guys all clear? Manu says, okay. Prince says, yep. All right. And Manoj, you have been quiet today. Are you listening? Are you there on the call? Are you there on the training? All right. Okay. Great. Thanks, Onkar, for replying. All right. Great. So that's with the overall embedding of YouTube, SlideShare, Facebook stuff, guys. Now, with the remarketing thing, whosoever was part of it, I've already told you how to get the remarketing code also fixed over here with the help of a plugin. So Guru says, advantages, we can see the likes and shares of Facebook. Absolutely, you can see that how many people have actually got done that. Plus, the best part is that none of your disk space is not getting used at all. Similarly, there are many other things which can get embedded. You can do some experimentations with your websites, with your WordPress-based website. You can embed your overall page also. Your Twitter tweets can also be embedded. Let me show you an example. If I go into the plugin section, click on add new, and even the Twitter tweets, the plus your plug Pinterest pins, all that stuff can be embedded. So you can see one of the plugin, it says display Twitter tweets using widget. All in all, you have to, you know, embed, I mean, get that installed and play around with it. Instructions would be given definitely within it, right? So try working around all these. I would say Twitter embed. All right, so you can see easily embed tweets in your post and pages. A lot of Twitter embed, Twitter button plus. So, I mean, it's huge, guys. It's huge. So many, plugins are there. So there is no end to it. So you can simply go ahead and keep looking for more plugins, whatever functionalities you want. So similarly, I just want to give you a brief over about Google Analytics, guys. Now, what Google Analytics does is, Google Analytics is a product which helps you to let you know how many people are visiting your website on a day-to-day basis, on from which your location are they coming and everything. So Manu, is there any special requirements for installing WordPress? No, there's no special requirements, Manu. You just need a hosting server, and you need a website domain and all that, and need to get that configured, right? So the way you get Google Analytics configured is, first of all, go into google.com/analytics. Like I'm telling you, analytics provide you overall traffic details of your website, right? So when I say traffic details, how many people came onto your website on what particular day, from which particular location, all that stuff can be known to you with the help of Google Analytics. And the URL from where you can actually get that configured is with this. So Guru says, when we are embedding, we should give importance to SEO, like editing meta tags. Absolutely, absolutely. You should give importance to that. And we will come on to the SEO part also. Right. So google.com/analytics and click on sign in. Sign in to Google Analytics. When you would do for the very first time, guys, it's not going to appear for you like this. Let me show you if I have a new account, maybe. All right, I'll take that account on me. So web analytics and Google Analytics are same. Web analytics is a generic term, Santosh, and underneath web analytics, we have analytics platform by Google, which is called Google Analytics. We have various other web analytics platform, which one is by Adobe, then there we have by IBM. They all are paid and they are very expensive analytics tool. We have Kissmetrics, we have a lot many. So web analytics is a generic term, and one of the web analytics tool is Google Analytics. Quantcast, absolutely. So if you would log in for the very first time, it's going to look very much like this. Let's say, okay, I would rather do it on my account only, just a sec. All right, so let's, when you would log in for the very first time, guys, on Google Analytics, since this is my old account, that's why don't go with this. The very first thing which you would get to see is this. So once you will log in, you would need your Gmail Google account to enter. Yeah, absolutely. Can you please log in with new ID? So, okay, this is the way it's going to appear for you, like with a new ID. This is how it's going to appear for you. Right, Dhruv, right, Guru, everybody, it's going to appear for you like this. It will say, create a new account, and within the new account, it will ask you for an account name. All right. If you still want me, okay, yeah, Guru, you can provide me your details in private. I would do it for your website. So I would log in from Guru's ID in order to get that. All right, so I would log. I would show you how it would look like. Yeah, this is free. And this is free for most of the things. There is a paid version also, but the free version actually does a lot of work. So, okay, I'm just typing in the username. Bear with me for a moment, guys. All right, so that's the username and password which I've entered. Okay, I'm not saving it, Guru. Okay, this is the first thing which you would get to see, and it will ask you to start using analytics. You would click on sign up. Once you click on sign up, this is the thing, guys. That's what I was telling you, that it's going to ask you for your website. So my website is this, right? So I'm going to take this and my website URL. I'm going to put my account name as this, website name as. So you can edit that anytime, Guru. So I'm putting it whatever comes to my mind. I'm just going to. All right. Just a second, guys. I'm just closing the other unnecessary tabs. All right. So what I've done, I have written the account name. I have written the website name. I'm mentioning the website URL. All right. And then I'm selecting the industry category. Whatever it may be. So let's say, as of now, I'm doing it education. You can change it whichever way. It hardly makes a difference. Then you can mention the time zone, whatever. Do you want more piece of information? Yes. Now it's going to give you again a tracking code, guys, a JavaScript tracking code. You click on get tracking ID. You would go ahead and click on I accept. All right. When you click on that, this is the tracking code, guys, which is the JavaScript tracking code, which is being provided. You have to embed this into your website. but I'm going to make it very simple for you. You don't need to copy that across. You would just need this UA code on the top. Copy this UA code, guys. Okay, I'm copying this. Now I'm going to my website. I go into my website, and within my website, I go into the plugins part. Within the plugin part, I go and click on add new. All right, so guys, you should do it for your website too. Go into add new and select, type in Google Analytics. All right, so when you click on Google Analytics, just click on the, and you know, get this very first one, Google Analytics, enable Google Analytics on all pages, get that installed, click on install now. And after clicking on install now, go ahead and click on activate plugin. Once you click on activate plugin, what's going to happen, you would see the Google Analytics tab, which is underneath the settings one. So you go into the settings tab and click on Google Analytics. So this will come automatically, guys, once you have installed the Google Analytics plugin. Go into settings and click on Analytics. All right, click on Analytics. It will ask you for the web property ID, which is this UA code. Delete this one and have your new UA code, which you had got from the Google Analytics platform. Go ahead and click on Save Changes. That's how your website traffic will not now get tracked across very easily. Now I'm going back to my Google Analytics platform. I would simply go and click on the property settings. I don't have to do anything over here. And let's say I go into the home part. And over here, you can see when I go to the home part, the home tab, it'll ask me for all website data. It will take 24 hours, guys, to get the traffic recorded. Let's see whether the traffic is getting recorded right now or not. So how are we going to check that? You have a real time. So once you go into the home page, home, and then the reporting, you have the real time on the left. Underneath the real time, you have the overview. Okay, now this will tell me how many people are there on my website on a real-time basis. Let's see whether it has got activated or not. I would go onto the website, just a sec, which is, the website is, so guys, you can open this website at your browser also and see whether this works or not. So I'm sharing the URL, guys. Just try opening at your end also. If let's see whether your traffic, if you are also getting tracked across or not. Let's do that. So maybe it might take some time to get the integration done. All right. Right. So it will take certain time, guys, to get the integration done. It's not, it doesn't get done instantly. So after 24 hours, Guru, you can just open your website on a one tab, and then you can, this is for each and everyone. Once you have implemented, guys, you can check your, after implementing, you can open your website on one tab, and on the other tab, you have your Google Analytics platform, and see whether this number actually turns into something or not. I will show you how exactly it works with the other website. Let's say if I go onto my other client's website. So let's say this is my client's website. I go into their real time. You can see the data, that overall traffic details are getting mentioned over here. Next class, we'll have a great detailed session on web analytics. All right. So if I go into the real time and I click on overview, right now there is one person. Let me share with you guys the URL of my client's website. So this is my client's website. So this is me on. Okay, that's what Rahul says. So guys, you can try clicking on the URL, which I have shared with you. All right. click on the URL and let's see whether you get tracked or not. So as of now, two people are there, and these two people are from what part of world? So we have got now four total. From India, we have got three people. Now turn to five, turn to six. Now from five people from India, if you have, yeah, so link is this. Through, try to open that. And you would see from India, we have got six active users as of now. And we have got someone from Bhubaneswar. I think Dhruv, you are from Gujarat. Why don't you also open? We have got some couple of people from Bangalore. So it would be Santosh and Guru Prasad, I believe. There's someone from Bhubaneswar. Who's that? Anybody who's from Bhubaneswar? Then we have, okay, that's Prince, who's from Bhubaneswar. And Dhruv, if you would also log into that website, you will also get tracked. Okay, we have two from Bangalore, one from Noida, that's me, one from Bhubaneswar, four from New Delhi. And okay, so Dhruv, you're not getting tracked. Maybe you, okay. Nitin, can you also try doing that? You're from Punjab, so your location will also get tracked. So I think four of us who are already from Delhi, Nitin has opened, all right. It's taking some time maybe. So we have nine people at present. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So Tejinder is from Delhi. I'm from Noida. And Nitin is saying, I have opened. You have opened the website which I have shared. I hope that's what you have opened, right? All right. So most of the time it gives right information. Maybe are you, maybe your overall traffic details. So we have someone from Pune as well. Okay. Is there someone over here from Pune? Guru Prasad, website is not responsive. No, the theme hasn't got installed properly. Otherwise, it is responsive, Dhruv. So I would actually give you responsive thing only. Don't worry on that. So let me see why Gujarat and okay, Onkar is from Pune. So why Gujarat and Punjab are missing? What's the deal? Why Gujarat? Why my state is not coming? That's what. Why Punjab and Gujarat are not coming? Okay, let me see that again. So real time overall audience. Stick onto the website, guys. Be there. Let's see how. Why is it not coming? And real time overview. So we have 11 people as of now. And if I check for the locations part, so we have got 10 people from India as of now. Yes, I'm refreshing and some problem with Punjab and Gujarat. Man, you got to really do something. I'm just kidding. There might be some IP issue, guys. That's what. You might be getting an IP which is from a different location. So that's a possibility, right? All right, so five people from New Delhi. So maybe you're getting tracked under Delhi, guys. That might be a possibility. Not really sure why is this happening. And if I check for the traffic resources, majorly it's direct. No, Google Analytics doesn't only just track those people who are live on my website, but it will also track everything. So if I have to see the past data, so I have a question from Dhruv. Is it checking only that data which is live on my website? No, I can check the live data also, and I can check the overall other data as well, which is the past data, guys. When I say the past data, I would show you the overall things in detail next time, guys. Similarly, the last thing which I want to tell you, sir, I've installed Fevicon on older theme and still it is showing in my laptop are seeing the same. Okay, I would have to see for the Fevicon. I'm not really sure. For every theme, the Fevicon is uploaded in a different fashion. So if you have done that, maybe we have to check for the theme owner. Why is this? Because various themes have certain problems also. So in that case, we have to check for the team owner. Okay, guys, before I move further, would request you to please fill up the feedback form, please, so that I can get to know how am I performing. I've shared the feedback link form. Please help me in letting me know how was the overall session. Anything specific you are looking at, any other feedback you want to give, feel free to do that, please. So I've shared the feedback link, guys. So all those who have come in for the first time, please do mention your credentials, your name, email address, and phone number also. Tejinder, Rahul Roy, and Prince, and Onkar. Manu also, if I don't have your details. So you can mention your details, guys. Manu, I haven't created your cPanel yet. So I would create that definitely. Once you become part of our DMP, definitely I would share the, what do you say, the domain. I would give you the domain. I would give you the cPanel. So I have to create your cPanel yet. I would give you that. Right. So I would request each one of you to share your feedback, please. Once you're done, please let me know. Thank you so much, Dhruv. Okay, you're part of it. Are you taking classes? Are you the same Manu who's taking classes from Manjeet? Okay, thank you so much. Okay, Manu, sure, I'll share that with you then. I'll do that. Thank you so much, Santosh. Yeah, Dhruv, I would definitely come on WhatsApp. Thanks, Santosh. Thanks, Manu. Prince, I hope you have submitted. Tejinder, Prince, Onkar, Rahul, all of you have submitted. So, thank you so much, Rahul. So before we leave for the day, thanks, Guru. Okay, I think Manu has already left. I didn't say that I'm done with the session today. Santosh, just let me know what all things have you asked about. Just let me know on the WhatsApp. I'll definitely send you. Thank you so much, Tejinder. So I would thank you so much, Onkar. Really appreciate it. I hope you guys have submitted your feedback, your name and phone number and email IDs, guys. Sure, Guru, I would do that. Thanks, Onkar. Thanks, everybody. Thanks, Tejinder. Thanks, Saurabh. Thank you, Santosh. Thank you, Rahul. Thank you, Prince. Thanks, Onkar. Thank you, Nitin. Thank you, Guru. And thanks, Dhruv. Sure, Nitin. Just remind me once on the WhatsApp. I will definitely check, Nitin. So next class, I'm going to let you know when are we going to have it. I think it's going to be on Wednesday. We'll have it, Santosh, on Wednesday. Not Monday. I've got another trainer. So I've got a training from Google. So I have to train myself as well. So I've got a training scheduled now on Mondays. So we'll probably have it on Wednesdays. So Sources did uploading any analytics training. Did uploaded any analytics training video in your channel? I think I have not. I have not done that yet. So, yeah. All right. So we'll meet next on Wednesday, guys. And yes, Onkar, I would definitely help you. Just WhatsApp me across. I can definitely help you with that. And next time we are going to, after the WordPress, we would start with Facebook marketing and SEO. So that's the next thing. So we'll start with Facebook marketing and search engine optimization. All right. So yeah, I mean, analytics also, I would absolutely, within on-page optimization, I would take, much more depth into the Google Analytics part, right? So yes, I would share the Google AdWords certification questions also. So all those who are part of DMP, I would give you the Google AdWords coupons. I'll give you the website. I'll give you the theme. I'll give you the overall certifications. So, Dhruv has got the certifications. I would want, Nitin, if you can share your email ID and password, I have to get you the certifications. Santosh, Guru, you would also need to share with me your Gmail ID and password so that I can get you these Google certifications. So, okay, Rahul, you're a little bit confused about what, so I will help you. Don't worry. So, can we download the YouTube links? Absolutely, Santosh. Take help from Guru on how, what is the procedure of downloading it, because Guru knows the way to download YouTube videos. So, how will I clear certification? So, whatever we are working right now, whatever we are studying right now, that's going to be part of overall your certification exam. And plus, I will give you more question and answers which you would have to study. So, a lot of material would be provided by me. All those questions which come in the exam, I would give you that as well. So, there's going to be help from that way also. So, I'll help you first from my giving from my side. You told the links are not working. Sorry, which links are not working? Santosh, I'm sorry, can you help me recall? The YouTube links are working. Thanks, Onkar, definitely for sure. And YouTube links is working, Santosh. It was one video which was not. Okay, no worries. So that's the URL for accessing the videos, guys. And whatever questions, queries you further have, feel free to buzz me across on my email or on my WhatsApp. So I hope most of you have my number. In case not, I'll repeat that once more. So Rahul say, I have no degree. Like, you don't need. I can absolutely, Rahul. Even I've got students who are studying in 10th standard, who are studying in 8th standard. You won't believe, I've got someone who has taken online session from me, who was part of Jammu and Kashmir. He resides in Jammu and he's a 7th standard student, and he has learned all these things from me, and he's doing really well on the Google AdWords and SEO platform. So you don't need that. Yeah, so sort of also mentioned that nobody has those degrees. You don't need that. Companies ask that, that's a different thing. But your certificates, if you have great experience, you have great understanding of these things, companies would definitely consider that part. So don't worry on that. Don't worry on that. If you can really do well in this field, nobody is going to ask you at a later stage for your MBA or your BB or whatever, or MCA, right? All right, guys, thank you so much. It's 5:10 and we can have a group for lifetime. Absolutely. So I think Ashish, who's part of the WhatsApp group, he's not over here. It's just okay, Onkar, whichever field you are in, perfectly fine. All right. So I want to be sure, I want to be part Santosh, and we can have a group for lifetime. Thanks so much. Sure. So guys, you can connect with each other. I'm just gonna leave this forum open. You can connect. You can share your phone numbers with each other, and in case you want to. Right. So Rahul has shared his number. You can sort of add each one of you, add each other, and connect with each. Right. Onkar, your chat actually went private to me, so you can mention it in a public chat. So Onkar has also mentioned, Tejinder has also mentioned the phone number. Right, so somehow Guru, Guru, you can pass on these numbers to what you say, Ashish, and Ashish would add. So Guru, you can also make yourself and ask Ashish to make yourself and even Saurabh the admin of that group. So Saurabh also attends every session, and Guru also attends every session. So I hope you guys can be also the admin. So Ashish somehow didn't. Saurabh, you know Ashish very well, right? So Saurabh, you can ask Ashish to make you the admin and add everybody part of that group. All right. Thanks, Saurabh. That'll be great. So Saurabh will take the lead and Saurabh will do that. All right, guys. Thank you so much. Saurabh, I hope you have noted down the email, phone numbers of everybody. And Yeah, Santosh is already part of the group. Absolutely. Great. So you can definitely connect with each other. All right, everybody. See you then. We'll be in touch and we'll learn a lot from each other together. Take care. Bye now. Enjoy the rest of your day. Okay, sorry. I'm just gonna wait. You can note down the numbers in that case.